war that continues in Tamil Nadu, the rift between the rival factions of OPS and Sasikala and AIADMK, which is only widening with each passing day. OPS seems to be gaining from strength to strength, while O Panneerselvam now has at least 10 MPs backing him. Sources tell NewsX that Sasikala has about 119 MLAs at the resort that continue to back her, while 13 MLAs, including Ministers Benjamin, Jayakumar and Durai Pandey, are likely to swear their allegiance to OPS. The power struggle there between the two continues for the Chief Minister's chair, as every passing day sees more support that's coming in from O Panneerselvam. It's been a dramatic weekend where we saw both Sasikala as well as O Panneerselvam coming out and giving a press conference saying that they have the numbers, sounding quite confident, while Sasikala has those 119 MLAs tucked away in the Golden Bay Resort. O Panneerselvam at his residence, the power center of the other faction of the AIADMK, continues to see several party cadres, former ministers, current party MLAs, as well as MPs coming in support of OPS.
அத்தனையும் கூட இருந்து பார்த்திருக்கிறேன். அதனால் எங்களுக்கு இந்த சலசலப்பு புதிதல்ல. ஆரம்ப காலத்திலிருந்து தலைவருக்கு பின்னால் இந்த கட்சியை உடைக்க வேண்டும். இது பெரிய கட்சி, பெரிய இயக்கமாக இருக்கிறது. இதை இரண்டாக பிரிக்க வேண்டும்
என்று. Let's go across to my colleague Lokpriya, joining us live from the Secretariat. Lokpriya, tell us what's the latest that's happening there. A lot of activity that has begun at the Secretariat as well. Caretaker Chief Minister Panneerselvam also expected to visit the Secretariat today. What's going on?
That's correct. Caretaker Chief Minister Panneerselvam will be reaching the Secretariat here at Fort St. George at about 12:15 p.m. Meanwhile, Tamil Nadu Chief Secretary Girija Vaidyanathan is holding an important meeting inside the Secretariat along with the DGP and the Chennai Police Commissioner. We are being told that the Chief Secretary is taking stock of the latest developments and the law and order situation in the state ahead of the Caretaker Chief Minister's visit, following which we are expecting to brief to the Caretaker Chief Minister. This comes at an important time, as OPS camp wants to project that they are still in power and they are the one who is winning this particular race. Sasikala has refused to comment on these developments, and she chose to remain silent on what she has to say, that Panneerselvam is going to the Secretariat. So we'll have to see what is the agenda of Panneerselvam once he reaches the Secretariat, how long he will be present here, and if he is going to have any kind of meetings at all.
Okay, so tell us about what's really Sasikala camp doing about this, because it's very evident in news that you're telling us right now. The Tamil Nadu DGP and Chennai Police Commissioner are present in news that's just coming in, holding an important meet at the Secretariat. DGP and Chennai Police Commissioner also trying to take a stock of the situation when it comes to the law and order situation of the state. How is the Sasikala camp, with most of the MLAs still, it seems as though, are on her side, are dealing with this, where O Panneerselvam is asserting his position as the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu?
Well, that's correct. Sasikala camp is looking very confident after the two visits made by Sasikala to Golden Bay Resorts, where she interacted with the party cadres at length, talked to them about the need to stay united, and promised them that AIADMK under her leadership will form the next government. Sasikala remains confident. She refused to comment on the developments of O Panneerselvam going to the Secretariat, but she said that she is a lion. She has lived with a lion, so she has that capabilities, and she will not yield to any kind of threats. So very confident looking Sasikala as she spoke to the media yesterday at the Golden Bay Resort.
Okay, stay with us please, Lokpriya. Coming back to you in a couple of moments. Our colleague Sagai Raj is also joining us live from outside O Panneerselvam residence, where of course we're looking at a lot of people who continue to throng the OPS residents, giving him further support. Sagaira, tell us about the kind of people and the number of people who have come in this morning. Over the weekend, we saw how close to 10 members of parliament have come out in support of O Panneerselvam. Some MLAs also expected to join in. What's happening today as we speak outside his residence?
as I speak to you, you can see that there are a lot of supporters who are gathered, and what I get to learn is these are workers. They belong to a particular union called CITU, and they have come in large numbers, and they want to participate in the signature campaign, which is arranged inside Panneerselvam residence. And there were a lot of public who had come from various districts, and they were inquiring in the morning whether there are some signature campaigning which is happening inside, and they want to go forward and support OPS. So this is a scene here. The people are coming from various districts, and the people are coming from various districts, and the support is increasing. Let us go and speak to a few people.
Okay.
Ma, yedhik inga vandirukkeenga? Yedhik inga vandirukkeenga?
முதல்வர் ஐயாவுக்காக நாங்கள் இங்கே வந்திருக்கோம், ஆதரவு தெரிவிக்க நாங்கள் டெய்லி வந்துட்டு இருக்கோம். இப்போ அவங்க ஐயா வந்து கோட்டைக்கு போகிறாங்க, அதுக்காக அவங்களுக்கு வாழ்த்து சொல்றதுக்காக நாங்கள் வந்திருக்கோம்.
இடத்துக்கு வந்து இருக்கோம், ஐயா தான் வரணும், ஐயா தான் நாட்டுக்கு சேவை செய்வார். அந்த இடத்த விட்டுட்டு காலி பண்ண அம்மாவை இந்த இடத்துல நினைவு சரணம் கட்டணும், ஐயா வந்து நல்லது செய்வார்.
Backing OPS, they wanted OPS to be the next chief minister. Okay. Next chief minister, and they say that nobody else should replace apart from OPS in place of Amma. Back to you.
Okay, Thiyagaraj, Lokpriya requested you to stay with us. Coming back to you in a couple of moments, but there are many reactions that continue to come in. We'll take a listen in.
எங்களுடைய சட்டமன்ற உறுப்பினர்கள் யாரையும் அடைத்து வைக்கவில்லை. நீங்கள் அனைவரும் கண்கூடாக பார்க்கிறீர்கள். ஒரு நல்ல குடும்பமாக இங்கே இருக்கிறார்கள். இதை நீங்கள் பார்க்க வேண்டும். இதிலிருந்தே நீங்கள் புரிந்து கொள்ளலாம். சட்டமன்ற உறுப்பினர்களை அடைத்து வைத்திருக்கிறார்கள் என்றெல்லாம் சொன்னார்கள்.
நிச்சயத்த கி ஸ்திதி தமிழ்நாடு கிளிய ஠ீக் நீ ஹை. ஹமாரே தேஷ் கா பஹுத் ஹி மஹத்வபூர்ண பிரதேஷ் ஹை, ஔர் உஸ்மே பிச்லே லக்பக் 8-10 தினோ ஸே ஏக் ராஜநீதிக் அஸ்மஸ்தா கி ஸ்திதி பனி ஹுயி ஹை. ராஜ்பால் ஜி கோ ஜோ விதி கே ஜான்கார் லோகோ ஸே ராய் லேனி ஹோ, ராய் லேகே ஜோ அப்போ சட்டிஸ்ஃபை கரெக்டி ஃபைசலா ஜல்த் கரே. இப்போ ஜாதா பரிசான தமிழ்நாடு ஆம் லோக ஹோரோனா.
மோர் தான் 40 MPs அஸ் வெல் அஸ் 130 MLAs ஆர் வித் சின்னம்மா, பிகாஸ் வி வாண்டட் த பார்ட்டி. இட் இஸ் அயன் ஃபோர்ட்ரஸ். அம்மா இஸ் கிவன் அஸ் எ கிரேட் பார்ட்டி வித் கிரேட் ஸ்ட்ரென்த். 1 crore 50 lakh cadres. We all want the two leaves should be there, and we also want the party to have the power. So that is what, because Amma has given us the party as well as the cadres.
Let's go back to my colleagues, Thiyagaraj as well as Lokpriya, bringing us further details. Lokpriya, let me come to you now. Every single allegation that the O Panneerselvam camp is making against Sasikala is being rebutted by her with equal gusto. We saw how they were alleging that these MLAs are being tortured. These MLAs have actually been kept there under duress. But Sasikala went there to the resort, gave a press conference with the MLAs and their families backing them, saying that they are free to do what they want to do. So if they are actually free MLAs, the question today is, why shouldn't these MLAs be asked to step out of that resort? Why shouldn't these MLAs go back to their constituencies and find out what do people of Tamil Nadu actually want?
Well, definitely, yes, that's the question that is there in everybody's mind. Why are these MLAs not being allowed to go out of the resort? In fact, when that question was posed to Sasikala, she was very furious. And she did not respond to that question. And even at the press conference, there was a human chain formed for entry of the reporters into the venue of the press conference. They did not want any of the press people to talk to the party men present there. They did not want the journalists to interact with the MLA. So there were very strict restrictions. So this creates confusion. This creates suspicion in the minds of many people. And this is exactly what OPS camp is hinting at. the fact that these MLAs are being kept there against their will. Today in the Madras High Court, there is a case coming up where the police will be filing a report on these MLAs who are present at the Golden Bay Resort. The case will come up to hearing at about 12:15. So these are the developments that are taking place today, this afternoon, even as we speak.
Right, stay with us, Lokpriya. Thiyagaraj, quickly coming across to you, how long can the governor actually wait before he calls the house? Because we're looking at this constant delay, is seeing this chaos that continues to prevail. We're looking at some sort of charges of horse trading also not doing the rounds, MPs jumping the ship, MLAs jumping the ship from one faction to the other. What is the governor expected to do, who's maintained quite a silence over the entire proceedings? Thiyagaraj.
There are reports suggesting that governor is seeking the advice of constitutional experts as well as the legal experts, and we know very well there is also a disproportionate assets case verdict which is expected any time in this particular week, probably tomorrow or day after tomorrow. So disproportionate assets case will play a crucial role when it comes to Jalalita swearing in ceremony, because this is one of the cases which is holding governor to go ahead and allow Sasikala to form the government. And on the other side, what we get to learn is Sasikala will probably go ahead and protest if she is not allowed to perform the government. When okay. we asked the question yesterday to Sasikala inside the resort, she said that she is doing necessary arrangements to go ahead and protest if she was not allowed. And even BJP MP Subramanya Swamy has gone out and tweeted saying that it is not right that the governor is not allowing Sasikala to exercise her constitutional right, and they can okay. also file a writ petition in case the governor doesn't allow them to form the government on Monday.
Right, a lot of opinions that are coming in on how the governor has been really acting at this point of time, but of course the governor in his right to form a stable government, and he's just weighing all the options. But stay with us, please. Thiyagaraj, Lokpriya, will come back to you in a couple of moments. Many more voices coming in. We'll take a listen in.
पार्टी के अंदर जो बहुमत का नेता हो निश्चित तौर पर वो अगुवाई करे अन्ना डीएमके का, ये तमिलनाडु की जनता भी चाहती है. लेकिन जो सेंटर की भूमिका है, जिस तरीके से अरुणाचल और उत्तराखंड में भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने वहां की चुनी हुई सरकारों को अपदस्थ करने की कोशिश की, और इस तरह की कोशिशें कहीं ना कहीं उन राज्यों में भी उनकी है जहां उनके पैर बहुत हद तक जमे नहीं है, तो ये चिंता का विषय है. और जो भी निर्वाचित जनप्रतिनिधि हैं तमिलनाडु के, उन्हें भारतीय जनता पार्टी की ओर से अगर कोई ट्रैप बिछाया जाता है तो उसे बचने की कोशिश करनी चाहिए.
It's, I strongly condemn that, because governor should be respected, governor's decision should be respected, and constitution should be respected. Governor is not an ordinary politician. He has so many things to consider. It's a special situation what Tamil Nadu is facing. And one side, Chief Minister is there. One side, General Secretary is there. Why we are in a hurry? No hurry, because our Honorable Chief Minister was hospitalized for more than 2 months. Then we face the Jallikattu problem. So let us wait.
What had happened in 87 is happening now. So when it is a fight for power between the factions of the same party, how can they claim that somebody else from outside is creating? It is not our fight for anything else. It is a fight as to who will become the Chief Minister, which means it is among themselves. The rift is within. When the rift is within the party, what is the role of the opposition parties? I understand all these things. See, this is just they want to save their face. They are blaming on the other parties.
All right, let's go back to my colleagues once again. Lokpriya, coming to you, we understand the governor at this point of time has the constitutional duty of providing a stable government to Tamil Nadu, and perhaps that's why he's weighing his options when it comes to the disproportionate assets case. But the other point and the other argument also is, how long can the governor wait? Because today, this case is not listed in the apex court, perhaps for a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, but these 3-4 days could really be long and could further create chaos where the entire political scenario is concerned.
That's correct. There is a difference in opinion when it comes to the governor's role here, the way he is handling the situation. While one section says that the governor is right while he is awaiting the verdict of the Supreme Court, because there is a lot of chaos and political instability, and to prevent it from spiraling, the governor is weighing his options and deciding to wait. That will be the best option, so that there is no political instability, there is no inconvenience to the people. But on the other side, there are another legal experts who say that Sasikala has gone by the rule book. She has not flouted any rules. She has the majority of numbers. So it is the governor who is duty bound by the constitution to immediately call her in for the swearing in ceremony. So the opinion is divided. On the government sources clearly indicate the governor will have a say on this once there is a confirmation on the day when the Supreme Court is to give a verdict.
Right, stay with us please, Alok Priya. Sagaraj, coming back to you of what O Panneerselvam actually said, making a very pertinent point. It's important for all the MLAs today to actually go back to their respective constituencies, because we've been speaking to such a large number of people who believe that it is O Panneerselvam who should be made the next chief minister. Not because Jayalalitha thought so, because the man has actually proved his mantle, be it the case of water sharing with Andhra, be it the case of Jallikattu, approaching the Prime Minister on several issues the state is deprived of, or the drought issue. O Panneerselvam has proved himself to be an experienced politician and an experienced chief minister, and thus he should be elected as the same.
Absolutely, the image of O Panneerselvam has changed ever since he revolted against Sasikala. You can clearly see that he is garnering more support on a daily basis. Various sector of people are coming to his residence and trying to participate in the signature campaign. Yes, as you rightly pointed out, the way he has handled Wardha situation as well as Jallikattu, bringing a permanent ordinance and allow the Jallikattu to happen in Tamil Nadu, he was being appreciated, and probably this might be one of the fear factor which has forced Sasikala to go ahead and call for a legislative meeting and announce her as a CM candidate. Though he has announced on that particular day that she'll be the next chief minister, the O Panneerselvam has clearly pointed out that he was forcefully resigned by the family members of Sasikala, and even now you can see that though there are no numbers, there are no arithmetic which is helping Panneerselvam, but the chemistry of Tamil Nadu is with OPS, and people are supporting that O Panneerselvam should be the next chief minister. Back to you.
Right. Stay with us, Sagaraj. We have some more inputs coming in on this. Lok Priya, let me understand from you. Meanwhile, we understand how those MLAs are, of course, held back in the resort, and some continue to really come in support of OPS. But the MPs coming in support of O Panneerselvam, while, of course, the perception battle he might be winning, but do these MPs actually count when it comes to the number game of him being elected as the chief minister?
Definitely not. The MPs do not matter in the number games, because what you need here at the assembly is the MLAs. Those
right.
are the ones who will get the chief minister position for Panneerselvam. So for the MPs coming to Panneerselvam, it is more of a perception battle. It is used as a tool to convince the MLAs to come to them. That is the only advantage for these MPs to flock to Panneerselvam's camp. What Panneerselvam needs at the moment is a huge amount of MLAs from Sasikala. It needs to be an exodus. Otherwise, there is no possibility of Panneerselvam to stake claim to form the government. There is also the anti-defection law. Two-third majority needs to shift. Otherwise,
okay.
all these MLAs who are with Panneerselvam may well face disqualification.
Okay.
And that is what Sasikala camp wants as well. They have not yet dismissed those MLAs for shifting sides. They want constitutional-wise these MLAs to be disqualified in case Sasikala wins a floor test.
Okay.
So that's the game plan of the Sasikala's camp.
Okay, that's the strategy where Sasikala camp is concerned. But stay with us, Sagaraj, as well as Lok Priya. Some more breaking inputs right now coming in. BJP MP Subramanian Swamy has been slamming the governor's role. He has spoken to us once again. Let's take a listen in to what he has to say now.
BJP leader Dr. Subramaniam Swamy, how do we see this? Because, you know, Jayalalitha's legacy is, of course, up for grabs. And now you see O Panneerselvam making his own claim, Sasikala making her own claim, Sasikala calling Panneerselvam betrayer. How do you see this? Because, you know, you've been in the state, you've met with the governor. How do you see the scenario, A, politically, and B, in terms of the options available, what can the governor do, etc.?
Yeah, let me start with the governor. He was given a list of 129 or 30 MPs, clear majority. Majority being 117 because there's one vacancy because of Jayalalitha's expiry. So there is no rival claim. Always with signatures. Sasikala made an offer that I will produce them physically if you like. He said no. Panneerselvam did not even submit a list of five MLAs. Now, what is the governor supposed to do? If he is looking at whether she is disqualified in any way, he has to see Article 191, which lists the various disqualifications for giving office. And that is in particular being an MLA, because you can't be a chief minister without being an MLA, except in the case that you may get 6 months reprieve. Now, none of those disqualifications applies to Sasikala. Suddenly, out of the blue, they come this argument that there is a case in which a judgment is awaited. That's my case. And I'm telling you, as a man who filed the original complaint, argued the matter in three levels of courts, and hoping to win the case, I'm telling you that you cannot play fraud with the Constitution. The Constitution has laid down a procedure. Now, suddenly somebody says she's not qualified. Was Sonia Gandhi qualified when she staked a claim for a prime minister? I mean, she was subject to a disqualification because she had reciprocity restrictions on her citizenship. So she couldn't become. But are you going to start looking at what is the minimum qualification of prime minister? Has it to be PhD? I'll be very happy because I'll go singly probably qualify. But the fact of the matter is that these are people's representatives who are choosing her. Each one of those MLAs is representing the people of Tamil Nadu. So, all right, you took 1 day, 2 days. Now, 7 days have passed by.
So, how do you see this delay? Because there are many, especially in the Sasikala camp, who feel that this could actually be detrimental, in the sense that the governor seeking a week's time, that could lead to a lot of opportunities for us trade.
It doesn't matter whether it's detrimental or beneficial. The issue is that he had a list. There was no other challenging list. Nobody said that list was a fraudulent list. Okay? And she was ready to produce them physically. Give her an oath of office. Ask her to convene, the speaker will then, and the government will write to the governor asking the assembly to be convened. First thing you pass is a confidence motion. And in the meantime, if the Supreme Court decides that she is disqualified, then automatically you stop the proceedings and then have somebody else. I have in my party somebody called Jagdambapal, who was chief minister for just 1 day. The Satish Prasad Singh in you Bihar, he was chief minister for 1 day. I mean, what are the heavens don't fall if somebody, supposing I administer oaths to somebody to be chief minister, next day they are killed in a helicopter accident. Okay? You'll have to find a new chief minister. So these accidents happen, so you can't think of what all the accidents that can happen. The governor is doing wrong. He's a very good man. I have very high opinion of him. I've known him since 1977. He's obviously under some compulsion. I'm not able to...
All right. Subramaniam Swami, they're continuing to slam the role of the governor there in Tamil Nadu. Lokpriya Thiyagaraj, thanks very much for joining us for a moment. With that...